Hello, everybody. Please take your seats. And the front row here is not reserved for ambassadors and journalists. So I would like you to invite you to use the front row. It's like the first class in an airplane where you actually have a room for your legs. So please come forward. Yes. Very good. The programs I handed out to several people, there are more programs if you want the program. Yes, there you found it. Please take a seat. We want to start shortly. Yes, well, my name is Oscar van Dillen. I'm a composer, instrumentalist, a music theoretician, currently working also on a PhD. Been teaching in Codarts for 20 years. I have a background in world music, in jazz, and classical music. And I developed in the course of my teaching as an answer to questions of students in the world music department. I developed a minor program which teaches world music composition. And so you may ask yourself, well, what is world music composition? If we're talking about world music, then there are compositions in the different traditions. And with it, actually, it got the meaning of what I call now original world music composition. And that includes, actually, a lot more. It means original composing inspired by traditions of world music with respect to different attitudes of creating and of listening and of performing. Because that for me was a vital lesson in studying world music, is that different attitudes may be there. Tonight we have a great opportunity to listen to five of my students who are presenting their works. It is, I don't have, can I borrow the program to get the order? Thank you. So, the first student is Tim Povel. He's a Dutch composer studying in the Koninklijk Conservatory in Den Haag. And since there is a closer collaboration between these both of South Holland conservatories, there is a possibility of students of Den Haag coming here doing minors, and also to the Rotterdam students, you can follow minors in Den Haag. And then there will be a piece by Caspar Ulias, who is a composer and bandoneon player from Estonia. Estonia is one of the three Baltic states, the most northern one. And he is a student of Argentinian tango, if I'm not mistaken, in the master program. So we have both bachelors and masters in this minor. Then Buket Zor, who's a jazz singer, but she's from Turkey. And she composed also a piece. So she's also a composer. My definition of what is world music, it relates to one of the definitions, one of the founders of the world music education here in Codarts, Joepe Boer. He said once, in fact, you can say world music is all the music in the world. And there's a big truth in that, but it gives a kind of, is then Mozart also world music?
Yes.
I would say yes, it is a kind of 18th century pop music. It depends on how you look at it. So it's also a kind of challenging the traditional concepts we hold about it and crossing borders. Then the fourth item in the program is a special guest. It's a traditional Korean classical music singer who will be performing. I hope I pronounced the name correctly, Seorin Kim, and she will perform in an arrangement of one of my students, Sarang Lee. Both are Korean. And Sarang Lee is a piano player, but also a composer. She's also in the master program. Which brings to me also, like, when Europeans, like I was born also European in Holland, was taught classical music, and that's Mozart and Bach. And then I started studying, when I was 16, I was starting to study classical music from North India, and discovering there's classical music in India as well. And not just one, but two traditions. There is a classical tradition in North India, but there's also a classical, completely different tradition in South India. And so there's also classical music in China, in Vietnam, in Korea, in Japan. So classical music is also something which we shouldn't, as Westerners, claim as that is ours. It is not true. So world music, there's also a world classical music thing. The fifth student is Bagus Krishna. He's from Bali. Bali is a very famous place in Holland because it used to be part of Holland. They kind of invaded it as a colony, you know, and luckily we're not there anyway. Bali has a special background because it is traditionally the only Hindu and Buddhist culture in all of the Indonesian islands. You know, Indonesia is one of the widest countries. It goes throughout four time zones, Bagus, is it? Yeah, that's even more than the United States, I believe. It's huge. And Bagus is a composer and a Balinese gamelan specialist. So, I think that is enough talking. I welcome you again. Thank you for coming. And now we're going to listen to music and talking. Enjoy.